Okay guys, back again. It's Tuesday, trying a new format. Got the camera set up a little more fancier. So today's episode, what was I going to do? I kind of promised that I'd go into a little bit about drawing females. So with that, I was going to kind of break down a quick female figure for you. So going off of like what I did last week with the starting off with the silhouette, I'm going to do that again here. I'm just going to kind of ghost in, kind of like a powerful female figure. Let's see how that goes. You might notice one funny thing so far. This female figure is kind of unlike most female figures I draw, as she is flat-chested. But no, I'm gonna. This is kind of like my basic rough estimate here as to what I'm gonna do. I apologize for the cast shadows. I'm gonna work around that. But after I have this silhouette down, I'm gonna go in and start trying to block in some of her forms. So I'm gonna start with these shoulder blades. I'm actually on the road right now at my parents' house up in American Canyon. For those of you who know where American Canyon is, it is situated between Napa Valley and Vallejo, California, in the Bay Area. So as you can see, I'm gonna just kind of start blocking in some of her shapes. Now, when I think of females, I think of curves. I think of soft edges. Usually, when I draw men, I kind of try and think of more angles. But women, I like to think curves. I like to think soft. I like to keep it clean. You don't need a whole lot of lines to define what you're doing when drawing a female figure. My belief usually is the less the better. Otherwise they end up coming out looking old or worn. So we got a bunch of big swooping curves going on here. As you can see, she's starting to take form here. Like I said last week, use that silhouette as kind of a guide. We're going to go in and fix up some of this stuff. Nice little petite feet. You see, she's coming together. Swooping curves. Get that fist ghosted in there. We got those boobs on there. We got her head. We're gonna try and situate her head a little bit better. Connect it. Having a neck helps. There you go. You kind of have like strong female form there. So with this, you know, we can kind of take it many directions. This is kind of proportionate to probably the way that I would draw a Supergirl. True Supergirl for many issues. So why not go ahead and take this to Supergirl, and that's what we'll do. We'll make it Supergirl. So now I'm going to go back and ghost in some of these facial features. I'll pull my hand back every so often just so you can see what I'm doing. So kind of put in that nose and that brow and that mouth. Let's do the mouth. And at this point, once I get the eyes in there, which you'll see right as my cast shadow goes away here, tricky old cast shadows, nobody's friend, definitely not mine, you can kind of see the face there. Just run a little more light. Maybe that'll help with those. Now we got a cast shadow from somewhere else. A little bit less on the drawing. Let's go in and clean up her jawline. You can kind of see her coming to life here already. This is a quick little female figure sketch. Supergirl, I always draw her with the heavy bangs. Swooping bangs. Now I'm going to draw the Michael Turner version. The mini skirt and the midriff shirt. So there you go, you can kind of see her face there. And with Supergirl's costume, I usually like to take her cape from shoulder to shoulder, like so. Come in and do the bottom with the ribbing of her cape. Put her cape in there, looking nice. Coming and dropping some of those lines for her costume details. She's got the low sleeves. Alright, like so. Looking good. Throw on this line for her belt. When I drew Supergirl, I drew her with a studded belt, but we're just gonna kinda do like regular looking belt for now. Oh, tricky pencil, breaking the lid on me. This is faultiness. Ta-da! Backup pencil tarb. That's drama. Oh, you son of a gun. Pencil's breaking left and right. It's my style. Breaking pencils. Nah, nah, nah. She got her skirt on there. There you can go. Give her her boots. Fancy boots. I'm gonna go in on the trickiest part on most super characters and draw that S. For those of you who want to know, the best way to approach that Superman S, that Superman emblem, it's actually two fish. See, there's one fish. There's two fish. One fish, two fish. Pretty cool, huh? So there you have kind of like a real basic outline for the way that I approach like a female figure. Up next, go in and just kind of break down some of my theories as far as what I like to think of when I draw female faces, per se. So like I kind of did this in the first one, but women I usually like to keep with pretty big round eyes, pouty lips. Doesn't hurt to look at reference. You know, the internet is a great tool. You can find all kinds of female reference on the internet, just in case you don't know that. So, usually, you want to keep the proportions of the eyes to the nose to the mouth. You kind of want the nose to be a little bit smaller. You would do on a man. We gotta get these eyes ghosted in there. Really weird looking thus far. But she will come to life here very quickly. Very full lips. At this point, you can kind of go back. I usually like thickening up those eyelashes a little bit. Can make those eyes a little more bedroomy, as it were. Right now, she's kind of bald. eyebrows a little bit. High arc eyebrows, pointy. And the first one. Give this girl part her hair in the middle. Kind of looks a little like Megan Fox. Not on purpose. It's kind of the way it came out. This episode, this week's running a little bit longer. So again, female face. Like to keep those eyes big and round. Those lips nice and full. Whatever, however you like to play with it. I mean, it's up to you ultimately. As an artist, you can do whatever you like. So, with that, let's put these two little bad boys back up here side by side. And, yeah, like I said, this is what we have for this week. Also this week, I kind of wanted to say, I'll have my first giveaway this week, which is actually... signed hardcover of Fathom Volume 3, drawn by myself, put out by the lovely people at Aspen. Inside, I did a little sketch and autograph. To be eligible for this, all you have to do is be subscribed to this channel, leave a comment below, and also, you know what, spread the word to 5-10 people that you know who might be interested in seeing stuff like this every week. Like I said, we're building on this. We're going to get better. Things will get more clean, more put together, and hopefully more fun. Comic-Con's coming up in a couple weeks, and hopefully I'll be able to do some special things for that. Maybe even take you guys around the convention floor with me. So, until Thursday, you guys stay out of trouble, be good, and I will talk to you soon.